In this example, I'd like to look at the buckling of a 2-degree freedom system that's composed of two rigid rods of length L and supported laterally by two springs, each of spring constant K at these two joints. And so there's a vertical load P on the system, and what I'd like to look at is, or try and determine, is what load P will cause the system to buckle laterally. So by lateral buckling, I mean that we'll have some type of motion of the system here where, let's go ahead and we'll call this angle here, we'll call this theta 1, and we'll call this angle here theta 2. And I'd like to determine at what load values P is it possible to have non-zero values for theta 1 and theta 2 in the equilibrium configuration of the system. And to be able to do this, what we'll do is we'll write down the potential energy of the system as a function of theta 1 and theta 2. And so we'll have stored elastic energy in the two springs. So in the first spring, I'm going to have 1/2 k L theta squared is the extension of the first spring. And then for the second spring, I'll have 1/2 k L theta 1 plus L theta 2 squared for the motion at the top level. And then we also have the potential load, which is going to be P to second order 1/2 L theta 1 squared plus 1/2 L theta 2 squared. So that gives me the total potential energy of my system. And what I can now do is look at the equilibrium equation. So those will be the derivative of pi with respect to theta 1 equals 0. So out of the first equation here, we'll get kL squared theta 1 plus kL squared theta 1 plus theta 2, and then minus pL theta 1. And then the second equilibrium equation is going to give me kL squared theta 1 plus theta 2 minus pL theta 2. And we can rearrange this into sort of a matrix form. We can separate out all the terms, and we'll see that we're looking at an eigenvalue problem. So let's go ahead writing the first equation. KL squared, we'll have a 2KL squared because there's two theta 1s. Theta 2 is going to multiply a KL squared, and then we'll have a KL squared and another KL squared times theta 1 theta 2 minus P times LL 0 0 theta 1 theta 2 equals 0 0. So we can go ahead and call this K, we'll call this G, and so we are looking at an eigenvalue problem of P minus, or K minus PG times, let's say, a vector of thetas is equal to 0. So it's a generalized eigenvalue problem. And so we can solve for the eigenvalues of the system here by simply taking the determinant of this quantity here and setting it equal to 0. This is going to generate a polynomial, a second order polynomial. For P, which we can then solve to determine the critical value. So we're going to get two roots out of this. We'll get P1 and P2 is equal to KL times 3/2, I'm going to write it this way, plus or minus the square root of 5/4. And that gives us our critical load. And we're going to, the critical load itself, those are the two eigenvalues, but the critical load is the minimum of these two, which will be the one with the minus sign. So KL 3/2 minus the square root of 5/4. If we'd like to know what the configuration of the system is at this buckling load, what we can do is we can plug in our value for P critical back into these equations over here, and then we can solve for theta. So you plug back in, then solve for theta, so that's solving for the eigenvector, and that tells you the buckling mode or buckling shape.